Okay, folks, here's part four of four on my British Royal Family video section. Looking at the horoscope of Prince Harry, 15th of September 1984 at 16:20 in the afternoon in London. He looks fire, 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 but he's not. He looks with all that red hair as if he's got loads of fire. He's getting to look more and more like his father as he gets older. He's actually Earth, Earth, Earth. He's a Virgo with the moon in Taurus and Capricorn rising. He's got a little bit of fire. He's got a lovely Mars in Sagittarius. He's nowhere near, I believe, as feisty, fiery, provocative, headstrong as he's portrayed to be. I actually see him with that moon in Taurus as a deeply sensual person, probably very good with cooking. But with that, he's got a really strong Mercury in Virgo that's squared to both Chiron and Uranus. So he's actually someone who's a lot, lot deeper than you might expect. There's a very deep psychological side to his nature. And when younger, under 30, and indeed he is 30 on the 15th of September 1984, it's given to mental variation. It's given to mental, not so much instability, but wobbliness. But when older, it comes across as innovation, novelty, and opening doors where other people won't go. At the current time, well, Saturn's just finishing on his midheaven, so he's come through a bit of a public image restructuring, I suggest, over this last 9 months. And he's now got the next year of having Saturn firmly established in his 10th house. So I do expect him to take on a great deal more responsibility and authority over the coming year. Similarly, his ascendant, 11 degrees of Capricorn, his grandfather's ascendant, 13 degrees of Capricorn. I do think that with Pluto on his ascendant right now, this is the making of him. He's really waking up and taking on a great deal more responsibility. Thing that worries me is that in connection with the rest of his family, he's got stuff around this 21, 22 degrees at a fixed sign. Harry's got the moon at 21 Taurus. That's opposite his mother's Saturn and midheaven, exactly opposite his father's sun, and on Kate's Chiron and on William's Venus. So there's obviously a lot of familial resonance between the two, between them all here. But similarly, Harry's moon is going to get hit by Saturn around mid-October. Harry's moon, the Queen's Saturn and midheaven, Charles's sun, William's Venus, plus a number of other things in the Queen's and Prince Philip's chart around 22 Aquarius and Leo. Certainly, I would be advising anyone who's in a position of power not to be sending Prince Harry out into military conflict in early October. I think he's mildly at risk, mildly. I've also got the horoscope of Prince George, who, the baby, I'm delighted to say, carries nothing of that 20 to 23 degrees of the fixed signs element that his grandparents, his great-grandparents, his parents and his uncle all seem to have. However, the ways in which George chose to be born at this particular time is phenomenal. If he had been born a day and a half earlier, he would have had the moon on top of Pluto, moon square Uranus, and the moon opposite, a combination of Mars and Jupiter. All of this is in his chart, which is going to make him a very physical, proactive child. But he was born a day and a half later. And this is with the moon opposite the sun. He was born on a full moon. And as a result, he's got a very similar chart in certain ways to that of his mother. His mother was born on a full moon. She's Capricorn with the moon in Cancer. But George was born on a full moon, Cancer with the moon in Capricorn. His father, of course, is a new moon in Cancer. So he carries on the local tradition of being born on a new moon or full moon with Cancer Capricorn as the aspect here. And I'm sure that one day in the long distant future, well beyond my lifetime, George will make a great king of whatever country it is that's left by that time, because I'm looking at 50, 60, 70 years down the line. This boy's got longevity. British royal family, there's something coming, and it's not too far away. I wish them well. Catch you later. Bye.